how early can I talk to my children about LGBT? And I'm talking about children, like, you know, what, at what age, and what is the best approach?
Okay. At the same question,
he's saying, would I be alerting him or making him interested in it when I do that, if he doesn't know about it?
Okay. In the West specifically, not knowing about it, it's quite difficult, because we just discussed it, that it's injected into the educational system.
Right.
So the answer to you is, as early as they're injecting it into the system, because they know exactly, Sheikh, they study where to put it in, what's mm-hmm. the right age. So now it's gone as early as grade 2 and grade 1. Subhanallah, I was shocked when I saw them trying to pass these legislations of introducing it in the curriculum at grade 1. Sheikh, 15 years ago when I was in teacher's college, or less than that, sorry. When I was in teacher's college, they were trying to force us to read a book to boys and to girls, young, you know, called I Have Two Blue Dads. And it was, having two fathers, you know, and being proud about it. I Have Two Blue Dads, you know, it's a rhyming book. And, you know, it's crazy. So, yes, to be honest, for me as a father of four, I talk to my kids, and my youngest one is 9.
How?
And I've been talking to them.
How? Can you give me a scenario? Okay. I'm your 2 years old or 3 years old son. Third grade or second grade son. And you want to talk how? Can you play this out for us, please?
Okay, so you need to be very, very, in education, there's something, and the Prophet would always practice this as well, that you got to kind of, you have it in you, it's planned, but you need to wait for that learning moment, where you find something that kind of opens up. So it happened that we were driving, and my daughter mentioned the issues of rainbows. You know, and that I see this rainbow, and some people are weird and they keep talking about the rainbow, right? And that's where I struck. And I said,
learning
okay, guys,
moment. So you have to wait for a learning moment, a time, but don't bring it up in a way.
You don't just want to, like, you got to be, as a parent, again, you got to be very much in touch with your children. You have to communicate. This is something, subhanAllah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to get to the level of the children. A young girl can hold his hand and walk him around. A boy would remember that he touched his hand. Remember the fragrance, right? That proximity is so important and vital for tarbiyah, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sheikh, you know what's important is that we're not coming with our own theories here. We need to tie it back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was the best teacher, you know, right? So you wait for that. You need to understand who your kids are through discussion, through priming, through probing. So if there's nothing, and you should know whether this is coming around them, then there's no need for you to just push it onto them. But be always alert. Mm-hmm. When the question comes, and a lot of parents make this mistake, don't talk about this, astaghfirullah, right? Yeah. This is not the way the Prophet ﷺ had a boy saying, Ya Rasul, allow me to commit zina.
No. And the Sahaba rebuked him, and he said, Idnu, come closer. And he dealt with his psychology and dealt with it in a beautiful way. Would you like somebody to do this to your mother, to your father?